tried my best, the best I knew, with just a regular nail file going back and forth over.
Is it painful at all?
No. Will that still continue to build up and become thick unless I keep up with it? Or will this take care of it eventually?
The product should take care of it eventually, okay. But getting out, so sometimes scar tissue forms down in here, or there's just a lot of buildup that's, mm-hmm. you know, causing the nail to be pushed in a certain way. This one you can actually see, it's almost like a ruched shirt or something. Mm-hmm. There's little lines in the nail, but sometimes it's getting pulled that way. So once we see what's under there, and clean that all out, oftentimes it does straighten out.
You know, she can do. I'm glad I didn't call. Like so many others, I purposely didn't trim them fairly recently to leave them so that you could do your thing.
Good.
I don't know if that's better or not. But.
It is, because if I can see how they end up, it's better for me to try to resolve the actual mm-hmm. problem that's causing it to go that way. Gonna thin this one out a little bit more before I trim the rest of it.
And that one I have tried my best, the best I knew, with just a regular nail file going back and forth over it for like 20 minutes at a time. You know, try, and I have taken maybe a top layer off. It's not as bumped up as it was, I don't think.
Okay.
But I knew I was getting nowhere. That toe gets a callus on the very tip of it quite often.
Yeah, I see that. So you just recently found my channel then?
Well, this was about 2 months out, and so probably a week before I called telling you.
Okay.
2-3 months ago. But I go to it frequently and see what's new.
Do you? Okay.
Some of my rewatch.
Did you know there are different types of nail fungus? I will give you a snippet here. There are mold fungus, yeast fungus, athlete's feet fungus, and dermatophyte fungus. And sometimes the nail can have more than one. I teach you all about it in my specialized pedicure course on my online nail academy. That module is included in the pedicure certification.
Yeah, I think I have close to 400 course. Videos on there now.
Individually.
Wow, that's a lot.
And that training is about 2 hours in total, so there's a lot of information on it. So check out academy.themeticulousmanicurist.com.
Sounds like you have a lot of people from far away. It sounds like you're so lucky that I might so close.
Yeah, that's amazing.
Yeah. my shoe quite often.
Oh yeah.
Cause
do you wear clogs?
Like
slip-on clogs?
Like what?
Slip-on clogs.
I used to, not so much anymore.
Okay. Is that when people walk, they lift their toes in those shoes and then they grip.
Right.
And that's a lot of people get toes like this
from
that kind of
repetitive
trauma.
Repetitive motion, not necessarily having pelvis.
Yeah. Yep. A lot of nurses. Straighten all the way out.
back in the water.
Yeah, but sometimes, like, some of your nails, like this one, the tip of your toe is kind of twisted and your actual toenail, I think, is growing to this side. Mm-hmm. So those kinds of things aren't going to change. You're going to have to maintain and just manage the shape of them to make create an optical illusion to make them look straight. Mm-hmm. Okay. But getting rid of the fungus underneath these nails and then the big toe and second toe on that foot, okay, it'll be about 4 months.
Oh wow.
Yeah. Not long.
Not long at all.
Mm-mm. Not long. I would say in your fifth month that you're gonna see as good as it's gonna get. At least that's been my experience with other clients with similar situations. Do you have any feeling in this?
Yes, I can feel that.
So that's part of your epinicium, which holds the nail on the nail bed. Mm-hmm. But it's separated from the nail bed, and it's also separated from the back of the nail. So I don't want to trim too much of it off, because if you can feel this, it's still living.
Okay.
And it has blood vessels in it, and it could bleed, and we don't want you to do that.
Right.
So I'm going to file some of it. Just to see how much of the tip of it comes off.
So that toe there hasn't always grown crooked like it is now?
It hasn't?
No.
Okay.
No, that's just grown since, like I said, from the last 5 years.
And that's when you took that oral medication?
Yeah. And you know, I think it was longer ago that I took that oral medication. I can't remember exactly. I know it's been at least 5 years, maybe 7. Sure cleared the fungus up off of my skin as far as the bottoms of both my feet and to my toes, but I don't feel it. Well, yeah, I guess it did clear up the nails some, because they're not very comfy at the word, but they never cleared up. That big toe grows out, will, and we take care of it properly, will that epithelium?
It'll reattach.
It'll reattach.
Yep, it will reattach. But you can see the discoloration all the way back to right here.
Uh-huh.
That's where the like stress on the nail is, still is.
Okay. Well, I shouldn't tell you this, but I know what you're talking about as far as it's like three separate layers down there, because to get rid of it.
Well, I can see where that would drive you crazy,
yeah,
for sure.
So the real white part closest to my nails, more or less healthy.
It's just detached. So can you, is it painful at all?
No.
Oh, the nail mycosis product?
Oh, yeah. So would that be something you would recommend for
Yes.
me?
Yeah. Yeah. That's what's going to help it reconnect to your nail bed. It's going to prevent any fungus from continuing to cause the nail to lift off the nail bed mm-hmm. and to prevent it from making any of the toenail thick.
Okay. Did you break this toe? No. Not that I even know of. But it's, as I age, it is kind of starting to form, deform somehow.
Yeah, it's like it got twisted clockwise, this portion. This is the culprit of this toenail growing wonky. It's got some buildup of tissue here that's mm-hmm. kind of pushing the toenail in a direction, and it's got this nail fungus right here in the corner. Mm-hmm. And I think that once that clears up, you're gonna have a whole new nail. Why do you choose to use the ingrown sidewall rasp instead of the ingrown sidewall cleaner sometimes? The rasp has a little serrated surface on it, and I can push up easier because it has a flat surface, and I can grab stuff that's adhered to the back of the toenails better. So that's why I choose to use the rasp at this time. Have you bought the pedicure kit yet?
I have not.
So the pedicure kit has the cuticle remover that I just used in it. Has the pusher, the ingrown sidewall cleaner, a file. You definitely need either the ingrown sidewall cleaner or the rasp to clean out from underneath here. Mm-hmm. To make sure that we don't get any more debris underneath. The debris is pushing the toenail up. It's pulling it to that side. Mm-hmm. So has it met your expectations so far?
Oh yes.
Oh good.
I kind of feel like you do it more, I don't want to say, therapeutically than cosmetically, you know, the other ones I've had.
That's a good analogy.
Yeah.
I agree with that. It's kind of like the difference between a relaxation massage, a deep tissue, or a therapeutic massage.
Probably about 17 years ago, I was going through chemo and radiation therapy for breast cancer, and I was off, and I just decided I was going to treat myself. That was nice.
I trust that everything's worked out with the treatments.
Oh,
good. These are going to be some good before and afters.
Good. So what kinds of things can you remind me to do about my feet being so sweaty as far as?
You can apply antiperspirant to the bottoms of your feet.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Okay.
So. Flat or out?
Flat first, yeah.
See, I pay attention.
Ew.
In the summer when it gets so hot, I tend to go back to my tennis shoes where I can wear, cotton footies.
Mm-hmm.
feet still get warm, but they don't. And the sweater, if they do, it's absorbed by the cat footy, and when I get home, take it off and change, and all that. But definitely, since, like I said, since the chemical menopause, I've not been able to wear pantyhose or knee highs on my feet for very long.
Because it makes them perspire.
And you know, when I was a little girl, I remember in the summertime my feet would do that so bad that they would blister and get raw.
Oh, wow.
So I think, you know, as I grew and then started doing my, you know, periods and all that, hormone changes, and now it's kind of waxing and waning. Now I'm getting away, you know, was getting away from all that. It's going back to how it was when I was younger before all the hormone changes.
Right. Yeah, hormones are crazy. They play such a big part of our balance. Maybe that wasn't as alive as I thought it was. I love almond extract in icing for cookies too.
Yes, I do too.
I love it, and a little bit of vanilla.
Yes.
People are like, oh my gosh, your cookies are so delicious. Like, what do you do? And I'm like, oh, it's almond extract.
It's good.
Thank you.
it's been 2 months since I've had a massage.
Oh yeah, you've got to get a full body massage with one of the girls here.
Oh, you do that here?
Oh yeah.
When I used to work, they would have massage therapists come in every Wednesday and you could book blocks of time with them. And it mostly was a chair, seated chair massages. And so I started with 15 minutes and then I got to meet it wasn't long enough, so I would book 2 blocks back to back to use my full lunch hour. And then I got to where that was and so then I started going to their office.
Yeah, that's good.
Full body massage, oh my goodness.
At some point you might want to see a podiatrist. This is probably turning into a hammer toe.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And I, you know, couldn't tell that until I was doing the massage and when I was pushing on your metatarsal bones, watching how those bones behaved. So when it starts to bother you.
So there are things they can do to prevent that or keep it from progressing?
They put a pin in it.
Oh.
Yeah, so they like break the knuckle and straighten it out.
Right.
Yeah. Saying that their toenails were different colors and she said, do you want me to book you extra time just in case? And I said, yes, definitely. Because anytime somebody tells me that their toenails are yellow or orange or green or black, there's a problem. And usually if they turn black, they're so disintegrated. Like under everything.
One of you ladies left your windows, did you? Down, did you? It just started like a massive down.
No, I didn't. Okay. Thank you, though.
Scoot over like an inch.
Sure.
There, let's go. Perfect. No shadows then.